Hey guys, welcome back! You've probably already noticed that I'm a huge fan of PC gaming since the early days of point-and-click adventures. So, let's track down the origins of the personal computer as we know it nowadays. Let's take a look!
The name William Cleland Lowe may not sound familiar to many of you, but it belongs to the father of the IBM PC, or personal computer as we know it, that started with the 5150. That's why my very first PC was an IBM. I wanted the best, and IBM was the only and obvious choice. So, back in August of 1981, the 5150 was introduced after IBM being threatened by a rumor that younger companies like Commodore, Apple, Texas Instruments and Tandy were about to start the whole and still inexistent personal computer market, and to save time, they centered the 5150 in the open architecture concept, using as many off-the-shelf components as possible. It was also during this period that IBM partnered with Microsoft, and both met the tight deadline to stay ahead of the competition. After the IBM PC or 5150, came 2 years later the IBM XT that introduced the standard of a PC paired with a hard drive, in this case, a hard drive with a mind-blowing 10 megabytes of storage capacity, when all others were playing around with tapes and swapping floppy disks. In 1984, the PC Junior was born, directly aiming towards the gaming home computer market, dominated by Sinclair, Commodore, Apple and Atari, that could even be hooked to a television via the built-in RF modulator, just like its competitors. Although, it's considered one of the biggest flops in computer history, mainly due to the problematic wireless keyboard. It seems that no one bought this visionary concept, and its price was still way far from being competitive. For that price, people were expecting a more powerful machine. In 1987, the PS2 line of computers was marketed in response to the rising dominance of PC clones coming from Compaq and many others. This new policy and the way IBM was planning to go with their PS2 line led to the resignation of William Lowe. Thanks to this man's vision and the risky move he made, home desktop personal computers are the way we know and love. The Wintel platform, Microsoft's OS installed in a computer powered by an Intel processor, became standard since IBM's 5150 back in 1981, and the number one choice during the 90s, and is still the main and probably best option for home computing and gaming. As you know, I still have my very first IBM that I've managed to buy back in 1993 with the precious help from my parents. It's a 486DX2 66MHz with 16MB of RAM, and you can watch my episode 46 about its restoration. It was a huge and awesome nostalgia rush the moment I pushed that start button. I recall inviting my friends over to play Doom 2 the way it should be played, and the first time they had a glimpse at this magnificent and imposing tower, they got completely mesmerized by it. What a beauty! For those late 90s titles, I also have an IBM, obviously. It's a NetVista model 6793, and you can also watch PixelThing's episode 27 dedicated to it. Just click in the rectangle shown on your screen. So guys, were you a DOS gaming enthusiast back in the 80s and mid 90s? Did you ever tried or played around with an IBM machine from that era? Those were IBM's greatest and best years. Stay tuned for a series of videos that I'll be bringing to the channel about my favorite PC games from the 80s, 90s and from the first decade of the new millennium. Meanwhile, check my other IBM related episodes, like for instance, the restorations of my PS1 486DX2 and my Model M mechanical keyboard from 1989. Also, don't forget to like, share, comment and subscribe to It's a Pixel Thing. Thank you very much for watching and I'll see you all next week. In 1984, the PC Junior was born, directly aiming towards the gaming home computer market, dominated by Sinclair, Commodore, Apple and Atari.